The topic of the month for August 2018 is maneuvering flight. We want to take just a few minutes to talk about maneuvering flight. It's still the phase of flight where most fatal GA accidents occur. More than 25% of all fatal accidents, and half of those accidents involve a stall-spin scenario. We'll describe common maneuvering flight tasks, and we'll discuss common maneuvering flight accident scenarios. Finally, we'll offer some tips for successful maneuvering flight task accomplishment. Let's begin by defining maneuvering flight. Maneuvering flight involves which of the items on this list? That's right, all of the above and more. Anytime we're turning, climbing, or descending, we're maneuvering. It's an essential part of flying, and that's why we introduce it early in the learning process. Stall spin accidents are deadly, and they almost always involve maneuvering flight. More than half of stall spin accidents occur in the traffic pattern, and most of the rest involve maneuvering, usually too close to the ground for recovery. We teach stalls early on in the learning process. Stall practice is intended to not only build power recovery technique, but equally importantly, to build stall awareness so that the pilot responds correctly to emergent stall situations, thus preventing the stall. There are a number of affordable options in angle of attack sensing and display that should go a long way toward reducing the number of stall spin accidents, but they're a subject of another topic of the month. For now, we'll say they're available and aircraft owners and operators should look into them. Every student pilot has practiced turns around a point. A training maneuver designed to build skill in wind compensation, aircraft ground track control, orientation, and division of attention. We are taught stall awareness, stall recovery, and stall prevention. And we're taught turns about a point. Although, we are never taught stall recovery while turning about a point. That's a good thing, because at the altitudes we typically use for the ground reference maneuvers, any stall would likely take us dangerously close to the ground, and a spin would ensure we crashed before we could recover. So for a few unprepared pilots, the first time they get to practice stalls while turning about a point is when they're concentrating on something on the ground. They're called moose stalls in Alaska, coyote stalls in Arizona, and roo stalls in Australia, all so named because they result from low-altitude maneuvering around something of interest on the ground. No matter where you fly, they're to be avoided. Here's a safety tip. When you're trying to view something on the ground, why not fly past the target in straight and level flight, then concentrate on turning the airplane and fly back for another view of the target? That way, you don't have to deal with the demanding task of maintaining a constant radius turn about the target. Yes, I know it's exciting to go fast close to the ground, and some folks get a rush from having an airplane dangerously close overhead. We don't know how many successful buzz jobs are done, but we do know that buzzing is involved in 32% of maneuvering accidents, and they're usually fatal. So, the safety tip on buzzing is, don't do it. There's another reason to fly higher, and that has to do with being a good neighbor. Especially in urban areas, helicopter and airplane noise pollution are problems we can all help solve. We pilots need to understand the importance of good community relations. We can't expect our neighbors to look favorably on airport improvement funding if our activities scare or annoy them. An airplane owner once asked an experienced instructor pilot, "What's the best thing to put in my airplane to increase safety?" Without hesitation, the instructor answered, "Gasoline." That's right. The most effective safety tool for any pilot is practicing the art and science of flying. That means more than a monthly trip for the $100 hamburger. Book some time with a CFI at least once a year to practice the items on this list. And be sure to document your achievement in the Wings Proficiency Program. It's a great way to stay on top of your game. Please direct any questions to your local FAST team representative. Narration by Bradford Wood, National Outreach Manager. There's nothing like the feeling you get when you know you're playing your A game, and in order to do that, you need a good coach. So fly regularly with a CFI who will challenge you to review what you know, explore new horizons, and to always do your best. Of course, you'll have to dedicate time and money to your proficiency program, but it's well worth it for the peace of mind that comes with confidence. Vince Lombardi, the famous football coach, said, "Practice does not make perfect. Only perfect practice makes perfect." For pilots, that means flying with precision, on course, on altitude, on speed, all the time. Be sure to document your achievement in the Wings Proficiency Program. It's a great way to stay on top of your game and keep your flight review current. Your presence here shows that you are a vital member of our general aviation safety community. The high standards you keep and the examples you set are a great credit to you and to GA. Thank you for attending.